Up next, someone who till now has been associated more with black, gothic black. It's 120 X-ray on Peter Murphy right after this.
My name's Peter Murphy, and I'm under the 120 X-ray after this.
Bauhaus were the next big thing after the Sex Pistols, an extension of the punk movement into the artier, dressier scene that became known as gothic. Now, 10 years later, Bauhaus lead singer Peter Murphy has just released his second solo album, and he told us that it has more of an upfeel than his previous work, and that's why he chose its title.
My new album is called Love Hysteria, and I chose it first before any of the songs had been written or any of the lyrics had been written, basically because I wanted to. It was a really wonderful title. It really, you know, summed up the sort of notion I wanted to put across, and that was not dark, sort of thing, more light.
Peter Murphy has just wrapped up a tour in support of his new album. Murphy is famous for his cat-like movements on stage and also for his creative use of lighting, and he told us the secret.
It's just basically using your brain. It's just like, well, if it looks crap, make it look good, you know. It's technically, it's just like you can light things from behind. You can use one light that's got a really wide beam to it, and normally you can't really use that very well out front. It just swamps everything in light, and it sort of creates a bland atmosphere. So rather than using it out front, you stick it behind a stack, and you can just get some shapes of the, yeah, you can use the shape of an amp to effect and make it just look like an object on stage that's meant to be there rather than just an amp.
Well, it's not just lighting either. Peter Murphy also gets involved in the video side of things. Now, for his new clip, All Night Long, he called upon the services of Matt Mohorin, who is a New York director who worked on the video for Peter Gabriel's Mercy Street.
I asked him to come to London to film it because I couldn't leave London at the time. And so that was a bit of a risk for him because he'd obviously got used to working with American crews. And it worked out real well. We did it over 2 days. Actually, one day, we booked 2 days, but my daughter was born on the first day, so we couldn't really film on the first day. So it looked like $30,000 was going down the drain, which is how much it cost. And we did it, and it's turned out exactly as I wanted it, I think.
Shot the concert footage for Peter Murphy earlier this year, in fact February, at the RPM Club in Toronto. I reviewed the gig, it caught me totally by surprise, and my editor Mark Keegel and I were both excited about what we saw on videotape and what I had seen the night before. We put together a great review of the concert, and this is how I saw Peter Murphy and reviewed it when Christopher Ward came to visit the Rock Flash desk in February of 1987 over at the old building. Earlier this week, you interviewed a very interesting gentleman by the name of Peter Murphy. Mm-hmm. How did you find him in the interview?
I found him actually very easygoing. There was almost an innocence about the man, which is surprising when you consider all that he's been through.
Did he remind you of anybody?
Specifically, no. I mean, he had a great face, though.
In concert, he has picked up the stylish crown discarded by Ziggy Stardust and Aladdin Sane.
Okay, all right, I can see that, yeah.
On Thursday night, I was given a real treat at the RPM Club here in Toronto. A packed house of over 1,000 people caught Peter Murphy and his band, and it ranks as one of the best concerts I've seen over the last 12 months, and certainly in the top 10 concerts over the last 3 years. It was very, very, very good. It was theatrical, energetic. The band was incredibly tight. He didn't let up. He played the lights really, really well. He satisfied the old guard, the old Bauhaus fans. He played She's in Parties and Kick in the Eye, so that those Bauhaus fans went nuts. For the new fans, he played almost all his new album, Should the World Fail to Fall Apart, and a lot of that stuff is just gorgeous and moody. And he also included stuff from his new EP, Blue Heart, including the song The Light Pours Out of Me. And here it is, The Light Pours Out of Me, live, 90 seconds of it, from last Thursday night. And what a treat it is. Take a look.
Thank you.
was a stunning concert, and one thing was evident. Peter Murphy is here to stay, and in a big way. Long live Peter Murphy. Bauhaus is dead.
When the band Bauhaus was at their height, they had some of the most fiercely loyal fans ever. So much so that when Peter Murphy, lead singer of the band, did a show in Toronto, the Bauhaus fans turned up in droves.
Strange, because that gothic group disbanded years ago, and Peter's gone on and done a project called Dally's Car. Most recently, he's released a solo album called Should the World Fail to Fall Apart. But we're getting way ahead of our story here. We've never interviewed Peter Murphy before, and we've got a lot of ground to cover. Bauhaus was a band that was surrounded in mystery, and that still holds true to...
Four of us in one room together, we would be, like, it'd be very tense, very, you know, like, it was just a really neurotic band, basically. Backstage, we were very sort of serious about what we were doing, and we were quite nervous of each other. We were all really strong, powerful individuals, I suppose, but different. So we sort of sparked off, and that's what made the music so mysterious, I suppose. Mystery just means, I think it's when you convey something that isn't of a norm, which isn't saying, baby, I love you, and, you know, we woke up together, and we're going to be married, and all that stuff.
The name of your album is Should the World Fail to Fall Apart. I'm wondering if that was the sentiment after the demise of Bauhaus.
Well, you know, we really, really committed ourselves heavily to that band, and we took ourselves through one hell of a journey, really. And it was very powerful. The whole thing was very powerful for us. So splitting up, rationally, we were very clear about it. We felt like if we were to carry on, we would become parodies of ourselves. But the actual sort of subconscious effect it had on us, for me personally, was like stepping off a steam drain, you know, that had been going for 100 miles an hour for 5 years. So, like, it was really a weird period. It was a heavy period, which was riddled with pain and fear and, like, insecurity. But coming out the other side of that, which was necessary to go through, you know, you develop much more clarity about what you are and how you want to do things.
Rock and roll has lost a lot of its rebel element. You still seem to have a dangerous side to your work. Was it dangerous putting together this new album?
Danger as in just not knowing what was going to come out, you know, the other end. I think you're talking about something that people pick up as danger, but is really wants to keep it vital and not necessarily crafting it to like a commercial end, which becomes safe. You know, so like I suppose technically and stylistically it's dangerous. And on stage I think the danger is important in that the live performance should always be of the moment and not choreographed in any way. So, like, I'm constantly sort of trying to rebel against my own patterns of working, like, in order to bring something new out, which an audience feels immediately by that. You know.
Like his live show, his new video for...
Who is behind Folks, he's a choreographer, has worked with, like, in the Martha Graham technique, which is like a technique which actually gave birth to what is now known as the contemporary dance, been working with me for a long time, just shaping me up and getting me to really, making me strong enough, like, in order to do what I wanted to do rather than her choreographing something on me. So when I did the video, like, I wanted to keep it really simple and I wanted her to really throw in what she thought was right for me.
For you to think of the movement that you did on stage as dance, was it more just something you did when you sang?
There's a thin dividing line between, say, what Lindsay Kemp does and what I do. It's actually named theatre, in Lindsay's case, and, like, it's presented in that package. And, like, in my case, I'm on a stage and it's a band, and I'm lumped in with every other bloody rock star that comes along. So when I talk about theatricality, like, I talk about it from, like, a very personalised point of view. that, and looking at Lindsay Kemp, for instance, like I can say, well, that's, I identify more with that than with print.
Like you're someone in a band. Some people say that you have the perfect rock star face. Do you think you could do something else other than be in a band?
Well, I'm not sure. I'm a believer in recognizing your destiny rather than being led along by your fate. If you can understand that. And when you recognize what you're really supposed to be doing, you should follow it, I think, rather than be scared of it.
Next.
When we chose Bela Lugosi, like, it was a really sort of neat idea. Bela was, like, immediately not the classic vampire actor, was he? I mean, like, in England, it was Vincent Price, for instance. And like, he was fat, you know, like, he wasn't the classic gaunt looking person. So we were talking about the whole vampire thing and how it was really erotic and how it was very, very, he was the most frightening monster of the monster movies. Frankenstein was incredible. Wasn't really, you know, you couldn't really take it seriously, but Dracula was almost like really attractive, you know? And it was that we wrote it around, that idea, and performed it like that. And like, it was just a parody on that, but like underneath it was coming out. There were those that you recognize. Like it fitted perfectly within our set.
The vampire legend and rock and roll seem to go particularly well together. What do the two of them have in common, do you think?
It's the notion of the like erotic, of the distant, isolated, subtle like eroticism, which goes with the rocking. Like, it's like the shaman of old who could actually sort of command with his charisma. The vampire's got that sort of feel. You know, the perfect rock star, really. You know, like, he can't have sex, physical sex, but with his victims or his audience, you know. But he can have that sort of, like, erotic link with them. It sucks energy out of an audience, which the Bauhaus certainly did.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I hopefully give more.
Horror rock certainly predates the existence of Bauhaus.
I'm just reading that.
Are you?
Yeah.
It's
brilliant, isn't it?
It's wonderful. I think it'll make a better movie than a book, actually.
It'll make a brilliant movie. I'd like to play it.
Well, that was my perfect question, because when I read it, you were the person I was thinking of.
Well, it's strange, like, I immediately, like, identify with it. Although, like, it's important to take it as fiction. But it's like a good sort of vehicle to research, look at the rock stars in from a deeper level than just, you know, the usual crap of going hedonism and drinking and drugs and all that stuff. Because that's not always the case. Like, I don't need to take drugs and I don't drink all the time.
The street still screams of garbage thoughts. The stain of anxious eyes. Still we glimpse the fainter's note. As the battle's with ambulmen, but the desire to know the wise. The street still screams. The street still screams. The street still screams. The street still screams.
Derek, the production assistant and works on our show, said he saw you when he was 15 and you scared the bejesus out of him.
I scared somebody the other night. There was this really nice 17-year-old boy at the front. He was looking, loving it. And like, I approached him and he freaked. And I thought, what's going on? So like, I just held his head, it's okay. And he sort of went, oh, thank God for that. And he smiled, you know. But that was the most important part of that show, because, you know, I don't really want to scare people. It's just that, like, I'm not there to scare, like, I'm there to really act out something, like, and live something, and let somebody experience a show, yeah.
Call a person, raise the road.
Hello!
up on the new music, Frank Stallone.
Marriage and, you know, children don't equal, you know, prepackaged happiness and contentment. I think that it can be a great trial of ego, because you're basically confronted with being, with your individuality taken away to a certain extent. Your own desires, your own time. So it's quite a trial actually, you know, because the kids actually suck you. You know, they need you, you know, to be there. So you're kind of taken away from your own space in a sense, and that's quite a trial.
Oh, everybody, and welcome to another request video. This is really exciting. We're today at the RCA Record Building on Sunset Boulevard in beautiful Hollywood on actually a very gloomy day. And today's co-host, here he is. Give him a round of applause, Mr. Peter Murphy. Let's hear it for him. Hey.
Hello, man. Hello.
Welcome to Request Video, Peter.
Nice to see you.
So you're in town to do, I guess, three gigs. You did one last night at the Wiltern, right? And then tonight and tomorrow night.
Yes, it's a marvelous place to play. Wonderful place. This is my fourth visit to LA.
Do you like it here?
Yeah, it's okay. It's a bit of a weird place, really, isn't it?
Where are you from originally?
I'm from England, Northampton, which is a small town about 60 miles north of London, which is not far from an American. Yeah, that's where Love and Rockets live, still. That's
right.
Our old hometown.
I
now live in London.
Okay, and it's really interesting because I understand that the way you got into singing was like through your mom, kind of. Is that right? Or you would hear your mom sing when you were growing up?
Well, I mean, that was when I was asked about my earliest musical influence.
Mm-hmm.
And so, the most honest answer was yes, my mother's lullabies. I mean, I remember those quite vividly. So maybe there's an influence there, I don't know.
And they were kind of like dark lullabies, weren't they? They weren't exactly...
Well, yeah, lullabies have that quality of being very melancholic anyway, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
And so there was that very sort of melancholic, quite moody, sort of empty atmosphere about them, which I suppose has an influence on my music. I don't know really, I'm not sure about that, but yeah, that was just an answer to that kind of question.
Okay, well, you know what we're going to do? We're going to kind of reverse the order, and we're going to start out showing several of your videos today, but the first one is your most recent one, and this is off of your new album. Why don't you tell us about this video? And by the way, this one's going out to Rose and La Habra.
Cuts You Up is really the most colourful video I've ever made, and the video in which I haven't moved much. I think the director Behan, who's a great friend of mine. We did this ourselves actually. It was like a bunch of friends. It was me, Behan, and Jeff, who Baines, who's a lighting camera guy. It was a homemade video in a sense, and we decided like I wanted to capture that stillness of your projection that maybe like an actor has on a big screen. So we wanted to capture that, plus we wanted movement and surging of some kind, and so the simplest way of demonstrating that was to run. And so there's those opposites in it, really.
All right, well, let's check it out right now. Peter Murphy, Cuts You Up on Request Video. All right, we're back with Peter Murphy, and we just saw his video, Cuts You Up, and Peter, this possibly could be your biggest hit ever, wouldn't you say? Because it seems to me, I've noticed from people that, maybe have never heard your music before. A lot of people
saying, who is he?
Yeah, who is he?
What's
exactly
going on?
Right. Are you finding that too? I mean,
this has only become evident during the last week, really, since I've been here. I was here for 4 days doing press.
Mm-hmm.
And now, doing the shows, it's quite evident that something's happening. And, that's all very nebulous, for an artist. You didn't really know what's going on until you see it actually happen in charts and audience presence and things. It's all part of what you hope actually for your music, to be communicated to a wider audience. It's all great.
This is going to be a weird question, but I mean, do you care about making the money, or is it the artistic thing the most important thing?
Money comes if it's meant to, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I think the role that like any person in my position is in is actually quite full of potential. It's a great new communicator, this medium, I suppose, rock and roll. But the money's there, obviously. You want to be able to carry on doing whatever you're doing. But I'm a pretty philosophical. Like, if it all ended tomorrow, I'd be just as happy as I am now. So I'm not really worried about that.
Right. You've definitely made your impact. And in fact, what we're going to do on the next segment is talk to you about Bauhaus. And we got some interesting stories about Bauhaus right here on this particular program. But first, let's check out. We got... Isn't this great? You get to look at your list while you do this. So professional.
And who asked for the video?
You can go ahead and do this.
So we've got, what's next?
This one.
Oh, Superman. So this is a Laurie Anderson video, Oh Superman, which I haven't seen. I love the song. I saw her play live.
Okay.
Brilliant.
And that
was asked for by Will in Montebello.
And we got one other one after that.
And another one, Ministry, Burning Inside. And this was requested by Doug at Duarte.
In Duarte.
Duarte.
Yes.
Excuse me.
It's a beautiful city, Peter. You'd love it.
Duarte. What is Duarte?
Duarte.
Duarte.
To be quite
Mexico.
No, it isn't in Mexico. It might as well be. It's that hot of a city.
Excuse my geographical ignorance.
It's right next
to Duarte. I'm sorry.
Next to Monrovia.
Oh, right, that makes a lot of sense. Well, I'm from Wellingborough.
Where's Wellingborough?
Near Duarte.
Okay, let's check it out right now on Request Video. We're back here, Request Video, broadcasting live via Arcadios East Satellite to bring to you the finest musicians in the world. We have Peter Murphy here. And if you want to call in, request a video, maybe you want to get a Peter Murphy signed CD. We're going to be doing that in the next segment. The number is 714-977-KDOC. And Peter, let's talk about Bauhaus. And this is an amazing band because how long ago did you form Bauhaus?
We formed in 78 and split in 83, so we were together 5 years. And it was our 10th anniversary last year.
And this band lasted, like you said, 5 years.
It's been there for five very, very intense years, I suppose. And it's one of those bands that's still sought after by a whole new generation, which is quite wild, really.
It was an amazing band. I mean, you had...
Did you ever see us?
Like, no, unfortunately I didn't.
Did you hear about what happens? What we were like?
No, tell me, what were you like?
We're just a band. We played music on stage, but it was very... Who knows, you know, it's very, very powerful, I suppose.
It was like, people describe it as like a post-punk gothic rock style. Would that be?
It was post-punk in that that's the, you know, historical point at which we started. But, you know, the goth thing, it really came later. I think, you know, the goth label happened after us. And so we kind of, you know, set the tone, if you like, for lots of other bands. Not that your bands imitated us, but I suppose we had like an influence in the sense that our look was very influential, but our look was only part of what Bauhaus was about.
Now, what's weird about it is you don't mind talking about Bauhaus, but the other members of the band, who are now Lovin' Rockets, apparently they don't want anything to do with the Bauhaus heritage. Daniel Ash, right?
I think that's maybe something to do with their insecurity with their own work. I mean, maybe they feel, I don't know, this is a theory, maybe they feel that, you know, their own work has to be plugged more than their past work. I mean, for me, I know that they know that the work in Bauhaus was very creative and was very good. And I think it takes time for people to feel comfortable with that sort of comparison. Like, I don't feel worried about the comparison, because my work's just like an extension of myself, and myself was in that band.
So right. Well, you know, Telegram Sam, which is one of your Bauhaus songs, did you ever make a video of that?
Yeah, we did. Telegram Sam.
Because we have a Request Video.
That was an amazing video, actually. It was done in about half a day. Real quick.
Is there any way, do we have that video? Can we see that video? Is that possible? Okay, we're going to take a look at that. That is in our Request Video Top 10 Countdown, even today. And it was made how many years ago?
That was made in 81.
In 1981, and here it is 9 years later in the top 10. Okay, well, let's take a look at that. And then also All Night Long, which is off your last album.
Love Hysteria.
Okay.
That was requested by
Suzanne
from Yorba Linda.
Right. And
Yorba Linda.
You probably don't know where that is either, right?
No, I don't.
And then we've got your buddies, Lovin' Rockets, Motorcycle, where Brian in Hollywood. Any comments on that particular song?
Dan is very into motorbikes, and so this was his ultimate video, to film a motorbike as if filming a woman. So it's a very sexual sort of video, I suppose, in a sense that it's like an erotic film of a motorbike.
Do you like it?
I think it's wild, yeah.
Okay.
I think it's
really
good.
Well, let's check out all these videos. We're with Peter Murphy. We're live from the RCA Record Building in Hollywood. We'll be back with more Request Video after these three sizzling videos.
Sizzling? Sizzling. Okay, these are going to be signed, apparently, for... Who are they for? For some winners?
Yeah, well, what we'll do right now is we'll take calls at 714-977-KDOC. By the way, this is Request Video. This is Peter Murphy, former lead singer of Bauhaus and currently a solo artist, really hitting the big time. And how do you want to give them away? I mean, we've got lots of callers calling in, Peter. How do you want to do this?
Well, I think, you know, the person who maybe answers the question. Now, let's think of a question.
Yeah.
This is live and walking on the... Let's think. The question.
How about this? I've got a question.
What's the question?
How about the first three people?
Where was my jacket made?
Where was your jacket made?
In France.
Oh, okay. I've got a better one. First three people to call in and name one band each that Peter Murphy really likes, okay? And we'll come back on the next segment and we'll mention maybe, I don't know, several bands that you really like, okay, other than your own. How's that?
All right.
Okay. Why don't you tell us bands you despise? I mean, I know that's kind of negative, but I'm kind of curious. Which bands don't you like?
Well, those that I don't like, I don't listen to or talk about. I mean, yeah, I'm not like a divisive person. I don't tend to, you know, go around thinking divisive thoughts about any band, actually. Uh-huh. I think that there are some which annoy you, but actually, I can't really criticize anybody for anything, I don't mm-hmm. think.
Can you tell me a band that annoys you, though? I mean, or a couple bands, maybe?
I'm not quite sure. There are some that annoy me, but I don't really hold them in my memory too much. Just think, I despise these boots.
These Ugg boots?
The boots. Ugg boots.
Well, you know what? I'll take them off.
Let's have a shot of those. No, they're quite good, actually. I bet
Would you like me to remove them?
So we'll form a band called Ugg Boots and despise them.
With me as a lead singer,
that's
huh?
the way out of that.
Okay, another question. These are just ridiculous questions. Have you ever had, like, you know, when you're doing a live gig, like, just an incredibly, let's say...
frightening experience.
Yes.
Yes, I did in San Diego last time. Maybe the girl who did it to me is out there. There was like a very high pin spot overhead. Like, I was doing a song called Socrates the Python. It was a very sort of very moody, very, you know, dramatic song. And I was down in this sort of a position, lost in the song. And of course, this pin spot's overhead, and you know, you tend to be very very wrapped up in this light, and, you know, not able to see out of that light. So consequently, you know, you can't see the audience. At some point, at this very, very intense moment, I see this figure walking at me through the light, and I had no idea what it was or who it was.
Walking on stage?
Yes, I suppose it was, yes. I later found out that it was a girl, just, you know, come up from the audience and had walked up to me. But at that moment, I thought it was a ghost or something. I mean, it was one of those moments that makes you jump, and it happened on stage. It was a real jump.
What happened to that figure? Did she get removed by the bouncers, well, or what?
I thumped her and sort of, she got, no, I didn't thump her. I jumped back. I swore a bit, actually. And then I just held her hand and embarrassed her for 5 minutes, and there was a song called My Last 2 Weeks, which I used to serenade her with. So it was good, actually.
You just never...
I turned it around. It was all right. She just freaked me out.
Okay. I like the way you tell it. It's very engrossing. Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to check out a couple more videos right now. We got The Beloved doing Hello. That's for Lou and Stanton. And then...
Morrissey, Ouija board. Felicity asked for this, and she lives in Lomita.
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 You said it better than it really is.
Felicity in the Lomita.
And we'll be back with Peter Murphy on Request Video. One more segment to go. All right, Request Video is back. This has been great talking to you, Peter.
It's been nice talking to you too, mate.
Thank you. This is Peter Murphy. We are live at the RCA Record Building here on Request Video. You're playing The Wheel Turn tonight and tomorrow night. All the shows sold out, unfortunately. No tickets available unless they sneak on stage like the girl in the pin spot, right?
Yes, absolutely. Yes, yes.
Sorry. Okay, now we asked a question.
Favorite bands.
We got some winners, and go ahead and just tell the audience.
Okay, Love and Rockets. Sinead O'Connor.
Uh-huh.
Well, in Irish, it's Sinead, actually.
Oh, okay.
Sinead O'Connor. Loop. This Mortal Coil. U2's early stuff. The Beatles. Rolling Stones, early stuff. Everly Brothers. Elvis. And Bauhaus.
And there you go. And if you're one of those people who called in, congratulations, you've got a signed Peter Murphy CD. I guess that's about it. We'll let you go.
All right.
All right. Thanks a lot for being on Request Video. Hope to see you again. Bye-bye. Hope Cut You Up gets to number one.
Thanks very much, mate.
By the way, we're going to leave you. Tell us about this one, Final Solution. for the final video.
Well, that was done with dancers. I always wanted to use dancers, but in a way that was not like dancers. So, you know, we got like a lot of guys who I knew who are dancers, but we painted their bodies and had them throwing shapes. And so we made a filmic version of body shapes mixed in with just a headshot of a performance shot. So it's,
and this one goes out too.
Oh, well, I hung upside down too on that one, which is
wow. Nice.
Paul in Los Alamos.
What's that? Alamitos.
Well, that's his writing. That's not my pronunciation. Los Alamitos.
Thanks, Peter.
All right.
Okay. We'll be back more Request Video on Monday. Thanks, everybody. Have a great weekend. Hope you have tickets to the show.
Back getting ready to come out here. So we're going to start off with video so we have plenty of time for him to play live, hence the beautiful setup back here, because he's going to be doing several selections from his new CD, Holy Smoke, and I think one or two things off of Deep, too, so that'll give you guys something to listen to that'll sound familiar. Anyway, we're going to be back in just a few minutes. We're going to start things off right now with Jaw Wobbles, Invaders of the Heart. Welcome back to Request Video. Joining us now is Peter Murphy. He's finally here. We're very happy to have you here. And we're gonna get right into music, actually, live. He's playing here live. Which two songs are you going to perform for us now?
We're going to be playing Our Secret Garden, which is off Holy Smoke, and one off Deep, which is Devil's Teeth.
Okay, well, I'll get out of your way, and then we'll do some interview stuff in a few minutes, and
we'll
take a step along.
There you go.
Oh, thank you.
See you later. Take you home.
read each word like a book, with your spirit flowing over me. Don't bother to close your heart. Let's drink honey in the park. Swap hats and go for food to our secret garden. Oh, please come with me. How will you feel when all you have is all?
the firmament for the blood of the prophets out of your reach from your aching speed. We sorry first now on the brow, it's a thirsty grip with hunger now. Decided painful ends to win. The battle of the me so waver thin. Land between the devil's teeth, that which cannot be ripped.
Because we can, because we have you here.
Yes,
you used
nice
to play.
To
it's good to have you here. You play at so many larger venues. I mean, you're selling out thousands and thousands of seat venues, and you're here with 40 people. What's the,
well,
is this a good change?
Enjoyable. Yes, it's a wonderful change. I really enjoy doing this, and it's a good opportunity to come and play to us, you know, to these people here. Basically, it's good.
Yeah. Well, I know they appreciate it. It doesn't get any better than this.
Yeah, but also we're also playing to people out in the TV land, so we're not only restricted to 40,000 people. So there's 40 here, but 40,000 out there.
That's very true. Yeah, hello to each and every one of you. You took some time off between the two albums, between Deep and Holy Smoke, and you went to Turkey and you had a baby. What else have you been doing? Tell me about those things. Well, you didn't have the baby.
That's not relaxation time. That's actually quite hard work. You know, my wife had a son, which is our second child, and his name's Adam. And so when I stopped touring in 1990, which was in October, I took basically 4 months off and started writing in 1991. It basically took me a year on and off to write the album and to record it. So it's not really long, although it's worked out that, you know, the cycle is looks like more like 18 months to 2 years. But yeah, I've been working quite hard, actually.
Great. We've got some people who are calling in who didn't get a chance to come down here. They want to ask you some questions via the phone line. So let's go to the phone calls right now. Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi. I'd like to know if you've ever talked to Love and Rockets about just getting together for one night for all your Bajas fans.
No, we haven't actually talked about it. I know that Dave and Danny were talking about it, but that doesn't mean that Bauhaus were talking about it. You know, Bauhaus were four members, so, but you know, we talk anyway, socially, we're friends, but no, we haven't actually talked about a reformation of Bauhaus.
Would you go through it though?
What's the point, really? You know, well, you know, the band stands and, you know, people like the stuff, and I like the stuff still, but I think, you know, the emotional motives, you know, the emotional impulses that were there that made us play that stuff the way we did, are 10 years old, you know, they kind of belong in the past. So, you know, I don't know whether it would work. It would be awful to be a parody, you know, to come on stage and kind of imitate what we were. So I think, you know, it's best to leave Bela Lugosi rest in peace, that's what I say.
In fact, you had we let you choose the videos that we played on today's program. You chose a David J video as well as a Depeche Mode video. Sure. What was it about those two videos that you wanted to see?
Firstly, David never got around to sending me his video, so I haven't seen it, so that's the first ever chance I had to see it. And I like it. And Depeche Mode is a video that was made by Anton Corbijn, who did the photographs on my album cover, Holy Smoke.
And you have the pendant. Is it the same pendant that you use on the cover?
This is what I awarded myself once we'd finished mixing the album, which was in November. And it was such hard work. The whole album, as all albums are, such a head trip, basically. I thought, well, this album might make me a star. Not that I want that. But so I, you know, kind of awarded myself. This is quite apt. This has got suns and moon on it. So that's rather symbolic, I think.
Let's take one more phone call before you play some more music for us. Hello?
Hello, this is Rick from Santa Ana.
Hi, what's your question?
My question is, are you planning to release any live concert videos after this upcoming tour?
Well, that depends on whether we decide to film any shows, which may happen. You know, the tour's going to be happening in June for 6 to 8 weeks. So we may well film a show if we do, and it works out well, and it sounds good. We'll release it, sure.
Coming up, you're going to play two more songs. Which two songs off of Holy Smoke are you playing?
Keep Me From Harm and Low Room.
Well, go to town.
Thank you.
Thank you.
the low room where we wind our love loom. Don't you think it's wrong that I should get stuck in a room, the low room? You've been away a while while the art on the box cuts. Vivid life in action, shame and the shortcuts. Stuck in a room, frigid and strained, perfecting into action. Repeating the names in the low room. Repeating the holy names in the low room.
Thank you very much.
I need the microphone back real quick. And tour plans. You're going to be coming over here and touring in the States when?
In June, from the 11th of June onwards. And I think the first show is in Boston.
Okay, great. Well, we're going to leave our viewers with the sweetest drop. Thank you very much. Off of Holy Smoke, which is like trying to spit out. Thank you so much for coming down.
Roll yourself. We'll be right back. yourself away from me, unveil me from your layers, lay with me, let me plunder no betrayal, shame cast out, morning sensual fire arise, upon union, in union we'll flower, sail naked in our thunder. Drop, get the thunder up, back into the top. Sense I'm on the shame, feel no more to shame. With me in the morning, take me in the rain. Oh, come with me, yeah, come with me. Conquer and swallow me. Explosive creature tender, let's scream out like the sea. Pull me warm and slender, conquer and swallow me. Explode, sea creature tender, let's about you all day, calling the sacred breast, rolling Sunday day, give me what I thirst, yeah, about the sweetest drop, get the thunder up, rocking to the top, sense I'm on the shame, ain't no more to shame, give me in the morning, take me in the rain. Oh, come with me, yeah, come with me. Conquer and swallow me. Explode, sea creature tender. Let's scream out like the sea. Pull yourself away, immortal burn alive. Rocking to the top, sense another shame. Ain't no more to shame. With me in the morning, take me in the rain. Yeah, come with me, conquer and swallow me. Explode, sea creature tender, let's scream out like the sea. Thank you, good night, good day.
Is that in my head?
I hear it too.
Oh, okay, thank God. Somebody turn something down? What is that? Oh, it's back there. Oh,
I'm scared of this band. Their feedback's so loud.
Okay, my next guest, the former frontman for the band Bauhaus. He's here with his fourth solo album. Make his American television debut, Peter Murphy!
Away from me, unveil me from your lips. Lay with me, let me plunder no betrayal. She cast out morning sensual far around. To the top, sex on the machine. Bring no more to shame. Bring me in the morning. Take me in the rain. Oh, come with me. Yeah, come with me. Conquer and swallow me. Explode, secrete your tender. Let's scream out like the sea. Hold me warm and slender, conquer and swallow me. Explode, secrete your tender. Let's scream out like the sea.
I think about you all day. The sacred first, rolling Sunday day. Give me what I thirst, yeah. Drop the sweetest drop, give the thunder rock. Walk into the top, say some on the shame. Bring no more to shame. Bring me in the morning. Take me in the rain. Pour yourself away. Says I'm not the same. Ain't no more to shame. With me in the morning. Take me in the rain. Oh, come with me. Yeah, come with me. Conquer and swallow me. Explode, secrete your tender. Let's scream out like the sea.
Now that was That was Sweetest Drop. Very cool look on Peter there, huh? So like Iggy Pop is a parish priest doing Ed Grimley. He's gonna come back later. He's gonna perform Cut You Up. We'll be back with filmmaker Ismail Merchant right after this, folks. Gene Stockwell, Ismail Merchant, Carl LeBeau, and taking us off, Peter Murphy, Cut You Up. Good night, Gene. Thank you very much.
After dreams of distant signs, you pour yourself over me like the sun through the blinds. You lift me up and get me out, keep me walking but never shout. Hold the secret close, I hear you say. You know the way it flows about. It takes you in and spits you out. It spits you out when you desire to conquer it, to take your higher, to follow where you must be. With mistakes that you can mean, move the heart, switch the pace, look for what seems out of place. Cut you up. Yeah, on and on it goes, caught like a distant wind. Well, through the zero I will walk. Well, I cut the thick and break the thin. No sound to break, no moment clear, when all the doubts are crystal clear. Crashing hard into the secret wind. You know the way, it's twists and turns, changing colors, spinning yarns. You know the way, it leaves you dry, it cuts you up and takes you high. You know the way, it's paint and gold. Is it honey, is it cold? You know the way, it flows about. It takes you in and spits you out. Cuts you out.
This was the Iggy Pop thing. All right. I have trouble with these guys. Johnny lied and I try to be nice. They all end up giving me the finger. All right. It was great. All right. Hey, good night, teenagers. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Swimming.
disappearing.